समझो मंजूरी होगी, समझो हर آخری پہ سر آپ سنیں گے تو پھر آپ کو سمجھ آئے گی اس شعر کی، کہ سمجھو منظوری ہو گئی، سمجھو حضوری ہو گئی، سمجھو حضوری ہو گئی، سمجھو منظوری ہو گئی، کون سی جیڑی محفل دے اندر اے باہو دے لال ہو بن، جیڑی محفل دے اندر باہو دے لال ہو بن، خم نہیں او نیڑے آندے جے باہو نال ہو بن، مرشد دا پھڑ لے پلا راضی ہو جاوے اللہ، مرشد در اتے پائی جاتے ہو ترلا، حاضری در تیرے دے ساڈی ہر سال ہووے، دل دریا سمندروں ڈھونڈوں گے تے کون دلا دیا جانے، بچے پیڑے بچے مہانے ہو، تے چودہ طبق دلے دے اندر، چودہ طبق دلے دے اندر تانے ہو، جو دل دا ہو محرم باہو، جو دل دا ہو باہو، سو اویوں جانے گت بچھانے
سلام علیکم ورحمۃ اللہ وبرکاتہ. اب چونکہ یہ میلاد حضور صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم کے ایام ہیں, تو ہماری بڑی خوش نصیبی ہے کیونکہ حضور کا ذکر کرنے کے لیے کوئی بہانہ نہیں چاہیے, صرف عشق کو محبت کو ذریعہ بنا کر اللہ کا نام لے کر بندہ چل پڑے. اور ان کے منہ سے کوئی اچھی بات بھی نہیں نکلتی, اور ظاہر ہے جو حضور کے میلاد کو نہیں مانتا اس کے منہ سے اچھی بات کیسے نکل, اس کے منہ سے بری بات نہیں نکلیں گے. تو بڑی خوش نصیبی کی بات ہے, میں آپ کے سامنے چند کلمات کرنے جا رہا ہوں, اور یہ بڑے ضروری ہے, ایک بنیادی تربیت کے حوالے سے بہت ضروری ہے. بہت سارے لوگ جب محفل میں آتے ہیں تو ان کو اندازہ نہیں ہوتا کہ محفل کے آداب کیا. If all of you are not taking and raising the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so what is the point to be here? Whenever you get in this kind of marathon, you should be awake, and all the time you should be remembering your Lord by saying Allah, 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 Allah. So maybe it will be not too much difficult to say Allah, say Allah, say Allah, everyone say Allah. Is it difficult? Say Allah is difficult? If it is not difficult, one, then what is difficulty? You are sitting in the mahfil and you are just peace. You have kept quiet yourself. So it is against the manners of the mahfil, especially when we celebrate Maulid Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. We have a qida that when we praise our Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Allah becomes happy. It is the sunnah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you are sending durood upon Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, if you are sending salutations to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, so sometimes you have to say sallallahu alaihi wasallam, sometimes you have to say salatu wassalamu alayka ya sayyidi ya rasulullah, and sometimes you have to say Allah, 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 Allah. So we can ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if someone says Allah, if someone says Subhanallah, if someone remembers you, what is the reward of that? Allah, Allah says, Faskuruni yaskur. Allah. Say Allah. When you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah remembers you. It is the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If someone remembers me, I will remember. If someone dies remembering me, even he is dead, but I will give him life. He will be not dead in the grave. His grave will be enlightened with the noor of Jannah. So again, look at the process. Azkuruni, if you remember. Azkurkum, I will remember you, Allah says. Vashkuruni, and this will be the source of paying thanks to me. So on one time, if you are remembering, you are getting reward for that. And if Allah is remembering itself, it is reward for you. And again, it is your special favor that your name is entered in the people, in the list of the people who are thankful always to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And on the last, Allah says, وَلَا تَكْفُرُونَ. You will be saved yourself from the actions of kufr. Sometimes people use such sentences, such words, which shows kufr. So in this way, when you are remembering your Lord, in return, you are being remembered by your Lord, and this is a source of being thankful, and you are being saved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through all the actions of kufr. Allahu Akbar. This was the way from Huzoor Nabi Rahmat sallallahu alaihi wasallam till today. If you look at namaz, subhanallah, when you read namaz, when you say, Ihdina as-sirat al-mustaqim, Ya Allah, show us the straight path. You are in namaz, you are in Kaabatullah, you are in Harbin Nabi, and still you are saying, Ya Allah, show me the straight path. What is that straight path? Sirat al-lazina an'amta alayhim. The path of those people to whom Allah you gave the favor. And who they are? أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَالصِّدِّيقِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءَ وَالصَّالِحِينَ وَحَسُنَ أُولَٰئِكَ رَفِيقًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, they are the prophets, they are the righteous people, siddiqeen, they are the martyrs, they are the salihin, the pious, the awliya kamilin. Who are the awliya kamilin? Who are the perfect friends of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Allah says, الله ولي الذين آمنوا يخرجهم من الظلمات إلى النور. سبحان الله. الله فرماتا ہے کہ اللہ تعالی Allah gives the status of friendship to the mu'minin, the believers. Allahu Akbar. And if someone is believer, Allahu Akbar, then what kind of status is being given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Allah says, لَقَدْ مَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِذْ بَعَثَ فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا رَسُولًا مِنْ أَنْفُسِهِمْ يَتْلُو عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِهِ وَيُزَكِّيهِمْ وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةَ. And today is the ceremony of Subhanallah, Quran.
Subhanallah.
What is the link between Quran and Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Allah says, Yasin.
Subhanallah.
Wal Quran al Hakim.
Subhanallah.
Innaka la min al mursaleen. Ala siratin mustaqim. This is one of the titles of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Yasin. Allah says, I swear by Quran. The wisdom of Quran is in front of me. I swear by Quran. Yasin. والقرآن الحكيم إنك لمن المرسلين على صراط مستقيم. If you remember in namaz when we recited Al-Fatiha, we were praying إهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم. Now here, the explanation has come. Huzoor Nabi Rahmat sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has got the status ala sirat al-mustaqim. Everyone is behind Rasulullah sallallahu. All the prophets, all the messengers, all the awliya khamilin, they are standing behind Rasulullah sallallahu. And Huzoor Nabi Rahmat sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is leading them. Allahu Akbar. Ala sirati mustaqim. Today we are celebrating the arrival, the birth of Rasul Pak sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The reason is, when someone born, then the people tell each other, someone has born. But it was Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was not still born, but Hazrat Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam, after the completion of Kaabatullah, was making dua, Rabbana wa ba'ath fihim Rasulullah. Ya Allah, I have done my job. I constructed your house. Now I pray in front of you, bring that husky. Who can be the this God? Brothers and sisters, if again you look at the Gospel of Barnabas, this is the English version of Injil Barnabas. There's one chapter, the title is The First Man of This Universe. The dialogue was, Hazrat Adam alayhi salam was asking, "Oh my Lord, am I not the person who was created before, who was given physique first of all?" Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, the Lord said, "Yes, you are the first man created." Then Hazrat Adam alayhi salam said, "If I am the first man created, then let me know who is the person whose name is written with your name on the heights of your throne." And Allah said, "Oh my dear Adam, if I have created Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was not being created." There's another hadith, very confirmed hadith. "Lawla khalama khalaqtul aflaq wal ardeen." And the last sentence of that hadith says, "Lawla kalama azhartu rububiyyah." I even don't show my rububiyyah, my lordship is because of Muhammad Rasulullah. And in the favor of this hadith, Quran says, "Wala wa rabbik." Acha farishte dekh rahe hain naam jo abhi tak nahi bola, Allah ka naam nahi le sakte. یہ فرشتے لکھیں کس نے کہا اللہ, مصیبت یہ بن گئی آپ لے ہی نہیں رہے تو آپ کا نام لکھا جا رہا ہے جس نے نہیں لیا تھا. حضرات گرامی, اللہ تعالی کی یہ بہت بڑی مہربانی ہے کہ اس نے اپنے نبی رحمت صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم کی ولادت کی خوشیاں منانے کے لیے ہمیں چن لیا ہے. We are here tonight to celebrate the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If someone is born somewhere, then the people will not tell each other someone has born. It is Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When Hazrat Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam came as a prophet and messenger, he told and he gave glad tidings to his nation. مبشرون بے رسول اللہ
یا رسول اللہ زندہ باد محمد
مصطفی مرحبا مبشرون بے رسول یعطی من بعد اسمه احمد I'm giving you بشار the prophet محمد صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم now at the moment in the heavens is praising his Lord in such a way due to that ہم اللہ سبحانہ وتعالی ہے named him as Ahmad. And he is coming. Ke aane se pehle ye sab kuch ho raha tha. Hamara koi isme kamal nahi hai ki hum huzoor ki baat kar rahe hain. Ye to huzoor ka karam hai ki hum unki baat kar rahe
hain. Subhanallah.
Subhanallah. Wo hazrat dono ulama ki hum tasbih farmaye aur ye aapko mazid wazahat karenge. تو میں مبارکباد دیتا ہوں آپ کے اس فنکشن کو آپ کو. ایٹ دا سیم ٹائم آئی ہیو ٹو ٹیل یو بردر اینڈ یو ہیو ٹو واچ اٹ بیکاز یو ہیو بین سپورٹنگ دیٹ پروجیکٹ ان دا نیم آف مسجد حسین بیکاز وی بلیو ان رسول پاک صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم وی بلیو ان ہز فیملی سے اللہ وی بلیو companion. So Alhamdulillah, then Rasulullah said, Al-Husayn wa'ana min al-Husayn. It's not just Husayn is from me till the last day Huzur said, I will be, you can see me in Hussain. Allahu
Akbar.
And Hazrat Sultan Al-Azim, the king of the Gnostic, Hazrat Sultan Bahu, in his time, he started this mission of Imam Hussain, radiallahu ta'ala. And he announced that my Astana and my Darbar is for mission of Hussain. Alhamdulillah, till today, from 1st Muharram to 10th Muharram, this celebration of mission of Hussain.
Subhanallah.
One thing is Zikr-e Hussain, one thing is mission of Hussain.
Subhanallah.
Zikr-e Hussain can give you reward and sawab, but mission of Hussain guides you.
Subhanallah.
And Hazrat Sultan Bahu mein, I say 400 years back, he started the mission of Imam Hussain. And alhamdulillah, it's not just me, my family, we brothers, and all you brothers and sisters are being a part of that mission of Hussain. Alhamdulillah. And today, in about 6 acres, the masjid has been completed with education facilities. From nursery to master. The project is now through, alhamdulillah. But at the same time, alhamdulillah, we are getting the people, because of poor background, and many of them from them, they are orphans, so they are very helpless. When someone comes to us, we can't say no, because I know, when I will tell you, I have got 20 orphans, I have got 50 orphans, inshallah, you people will support them, and you will be taking care of them, because Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, who takes care of the orphans on the day of judgment, I will take care of those people. So just look at this video, you can see how, alhamdulillah, the people are being educated and being taking care, alhamdulillah, by you people. Maybe sometimes you don't know, if you do some nazrana or gyarmishis, we put on those orphans, and inshallah, the day of judgment, when no one will be in your support, then Rasulullah Pak will say, Ya Allah, this is the person who supported the orphans of my ummah, Allahu Akbar. Once Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was going for Salatul Eid, on the way he saw a kid, very sad. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam went close to him and asked, why you are sad? He said, I'm sad because no one is to take care of me. Today is Eid, but I have no clothes. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam took him back to home, Allahu Akbar, and gave him ghusl and new clothes and said to him, are you happy? Today Muhammad is your father, Allahu Akbar. And Hasan Hussain are your brothers, Allahu Akbar. The thing is, we have to be very careful. Even your own kids, if they are becoming Hafiz al-Quran, on the day of judgment, Allahu Akbar, Allah SWT will say, oh Hafiz al-Quran, because you have saved Quran, so today I'm giving you permission, if any member of your family is in fire of hell, you are allowed to take them out from Jahannam and enter into the paradise.
Allah.